Dreams are certainly one of the most fascinating phenomena that exist. Despite years of research, we still know almost nothing about them, because we can't measure dreams nor precisely describe them. Actually, it is estimated that we forget about 95% of the dreams we make. But what are dreams? Let's explore what we know about dreams. To put it simply, dreams are the interpretation of neural impulses done by the cerebral cortex that tries to make sense of the cerebral activity occurring during sleep. It tries to create a coherent story. However, because the prefrontal cortex responsible for logic isn't very active, we don't realize that we are dreaming. In other words, dreams don't seem to serve a primary purpose, but are a direct consequence of the reorganization of neural connections that occurs during sleep. Many mammals and birds have been observed dreaming, but the duration and intensity of dreams greatly varies from species to species. Dolphins are considered small dreamers, while opossums big dreamers. Younger individuals dream more because they sleep more and are more often in REM sleep than adults. Dreams continuously happen during sleep, however they are more vivid and extraordinary during REM sleep. Dreams are thus an accidental result of the neurological activity. However, some suggest that dreams may even serve a more vital function, as a threat simulator that could help us better react and manage our emotions in stressful situations. It could serve an evolutionary purpose. Think about it. During human prehistory, cavemen who dreamed a lot had better chances of survival because they were more prepared to face possible threats such as a mammoth attack. Mm-hmm. This hypothesis is plausible as emotions felt during dreams are mostly negative, but it has yet to be proved. Furthermore, the content of some dreams can be scary enough to wake up a person. Surprisingly, humans are average dreamers, and their dreams mainly involve the sight sense. But what about blind people, you may ask? They also dream, but mostly through hearing. Strangely, it has been observed that they experience far more nightmares than average people. Moreover, it is possible to be in a dream and know that you are dreaming. This is known as lucid dreaming, and it allows you to take control of your dream and to create your own story. Many tips and tricks exist to help you achieve this. Here are some. First, each time you wake up, write in a journal what you can remember about the dreams you just had. This will help you find recurring patterns in your dreams, which will eventually help you be aware when you are dreaming. Then, before going to bed, write a symbol on your hand and frequently look at it while asking yourself if you are dreaming. Eventually, you will start seeing this mark in your dreams, and you may be able to take control of them. Finally, when you are dreaming but feel that you are about to wake up, pretend to spin around in circles. Surprisingly, this keeps the dream going most of the time. So, we are far from unveiling all the mysteries about dreams, but in the future, will it be possible to recreate our dreams? Maybe. A Japanese team of scientists already tried to recreate dreams by measuring with an MRI scanner the cerebral activity of people when they showed them different pictures. By then comparing the data collected during wakefulness with the electrical activity detected when a person was asleep and dreaming, they managed to recreate a picture of the dream. The results were quite impressive, although not very accurate, but it could eventually change with the improvement of technology. The dream of recording dreams could then become a reality.